Let's talk about all the weapons in Assassin's Creed Valhalla. I think I found all the options in recent play sessions, including the dual shields, and I also used a lot of like two-handed weapons, because that is also possible and quite a lot of fun to try out. So really a lot to go over. A like on the video would really help the channel out, and let's go. You can, by the way, win Valhalla in my November giveaway for a 2020 game of your choice, so totally enter via the link in the pinned comment if you want to participate, and be sure you are a subscriber of the channel before you enter, and good luck. Let's start with the one-handed weapons. We got your regular axe, that is kind of the balanced weapon in this game. Hitting and breaking early game shields is possible, it deals regular damage, and it's overall pretty comparable to the one-handed mace. Overall, hitting an enemy with a weapon feels really great in Valhalla, but a blunt weapon has some extra weight to it. It's just more satisfying in my opinion. And another difference is that the mace is more focused on stun, so trying to remove the small bar above the health bar of the enemy. When that is empty, you can namely do a powerful stun attack that in most cases will finish off an enemy. Another one-handed weapon is the dagger, which is of course super fast compared to other weapons, but it has a lower regular attack and also a very low stun. So it's really just to quickly stab enemies. The dagger in the left hand though is my favorite left hand attack so far, because that's of course the thing, thanks to the new dual wield system you can use a weapon in your right or in your left hand, and you select that by going to the inventory menu. The weapon you put in the right hand has the regular light attack and the heavy attack with the right button and the right trigger. And the weapon you put in your left hand will be used for the parry, but if you hold the left button, you'll actually perform a special left hand attack that consumes stamina. And again, I love the one for the dagger, as it will let you jump towards a target, stab them until you got no stamina left or until they die, and they can also choose to go back, so kind of jump back with a cool animation. This will just take out enemies insanely fast and add some nice agility as well. For the mace, it will just let you repeatedly hit the ground until your stamina bar is empty, so it will actually hit multiple enemies as well, like here both wolves get caught in the attack and just cannot move anymore. But the axe left hand attack is amazing too, kind of similar to the dagger but without the leap. Like, Eivor will just go crazy and deal an insane amount of damage over a short period of time. But what is interesting about these left-hand attacks, that they seem to be even stronger when you have two of the same weapons. I could only try it with the axes so far, but equipping two axes and then holding the left attack button to do the left-hand attack will actually have Eivor use both axes to deal even more damage in a quick succession. So really awesome, the enemy's unable to do anything back, and overall when using two axes for example, it also makes you just way more aggressive. Regular attacks and heavy attacks now use both axes too. So it's really cool what kind of impact using two of the same weapons actually has, and I can't wait to try it for the other one-handed weapons. And no, I did not forget the completely new weapon that is being added to Valhalla, the flail, that I only got to try back in July, and it feels completely different from any other weapon in the game. The thing is with this weapon that you gotta charge it up a little bit to get the combo going, but when you then hit an enemy, you will actually hit them a lot of times after each other. And it can actually be used for hitting multiple enemies as well. The left attack button is also more of an AoE where you spin around to hit multiple enemies. Again, I really want to see what using two of these flail weapons will look like. And as you might know, we speculated before about a potential one-handed sword in Valhalla, like will that be in the game? It was spotted in the hand of Sigurd in the deep dive Ubisoft Forge video. And in that same trailer, we also saw one in the inventory menu. Well, turns out that was actually a two-handed sword, because we only have two-handed swords in Valhalla. And this was actually confirmed by Benoit, the co-dev game director on Twitter. He, in that same tweet, also talks about the heavy dual-wielding skill. I told you about this before, that it's quite far in the bare skill line, but you can unlock it pretty early actually if you really focus on going down this path. And if you have this skill unlocked, you can carry a two-handed weapon in one hand. Although it's obviously not the same as having a regular sword, which would obviously have been way faster than a regular two-handed sword. The two-handed sword is still the fastest two-handed weapon though in the game. You can slash enemies or multiple enemies relatively fast compared compared to the other heavy weapons. And I quite like the left attack for this one, because that's of course the thing for two-handed weapons. You will have both the right and left hand attacks active when just equipping one weapon. And with the two-handed sword, you can charge towards a target, closing the distance and also causing them to sometimes be knocked down. And also the final hit of your regular attack combo is great. Like, overall, the two-handed sword is a really fun weapon. The two-handed axe is way slower, but also deals more damage and more easily breaks the defenses of the enemy or interrupts the enemy. Really great against this skull enemy that was a way higher power level than me. And see me do the left-hand attack here as well, kind of a whirlwind, to where you hit enemies who are close by from multiple angles, and you can enhance this actually when having two-handed weapons equipped. So then you hit enemies way more when spinning around. The two-handed sword left-hand attack doesn't seem to be enhanced when using two-handed weapons, like you will still charge to the enemy. But regular attacks with both swords will have both weapons hit the target. And that's actually similar when you, for example, switch it up. So have a two-handed axe and a two-handed sword. And here you gotta think about your left-hand attack. Do I want the charge from the two-handed sword, or do I want to spin around? So use the axe in the left hand. Another two-handed weapon you can add to the mix is the spear. If you just use it regularly, then it will of course have a nice range, so you can keep the distance between you and the enemy. Heavy attacks are great too, to break defenses, throw enemies on the ground, so you can also follow up with a nice stomp. And using the spear with another two-handed weapon will just be nice, because the spear really adds some crowd control and range that you cannot really find with the two-handed sword and the axe. And overall, having two-handed weapons is totally not for everyone, because it significantly reduces your speed. But if you are okay with that, then it will be really fun to just go crazy and easily break enemies, throw them on the ground, finish them off. It's really cool that this is a possibility. And then I did not even touch on the shields. There seem to be two different ones, a regular round shield and a massive tower shield that you'll actually place on the ground to be even more protected. So if you want to be more agile, then the regular shield is great. But if you don't mind being a little bit slower but having better protection, then this royal shield, for example, is really for you. Or you can use them both. Yes, dual shields is of course a combination that is possible. And I gotta say, swinging this royal shield around actually deals quite a lot of damage. And you can even hit multiple enemies and charge towards them as well, which is pretty cool. And of course, you're way better protected now as well from multiple angles. So I cannot wait to see some builds that will be possible with the dual shield, because it's a really unique playstyle. I wanted to focus this video on the melee weapons, but we of course also got different bows. And if you played Origins, then they will all be familiar. We got the Rapid Fire Light Bow that lets you shoot multiple arrows quickly after each other. The Predator Bow is back for sniping. And then we got also a Hunter Bow that is comparable to the regular bow we had in Odyssey 2. Which weapons are you going to use? Let me know in the comments down below. Of course, subscribe for everything on Assassin's Creed Valhalla. A lot more videos are coming your way and already on the channel. A like would really help the channel out. And I made a Discord as well, which you can join via the link in the pinned comment. We're just starting out, but would be cool if you could already join. And you might already know about my second channel, Raptor Roll, for a ton of Valhalla. Raw gameplay, daily uploads are happening over there. So would be awesome if you could check it out. If you haven't already, subscribe there. You can click the screen here for the most recent video. For now though, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.